we're going to look at some Indian businesses which actually expanded to Dubai and what happened to them. Okay. One of them was Dabur. So this is a, like, you know, a very old story. Dabur will be somewhere in 2008, 2009, way, way back. Okay. And they were able to survive because their products were kind of, you know, used, or they could earn income from their products by selling into Dubai. Like we said, we have a good deal of Indian market. And from personal experience, I can say this, that sometimes when you have typical Indian products available out of India, it is like a reminiscence to you for India, you know. And I can really resonate with this, because, you know, being out of India, if you get, for example, the likes of a Kurkure, it reminisces you of the time when you were there, like you were sharing time with your family and all. Most people who are in these countries can be expatriate workers from India, and they really, really prefer to, you know, work up and look at buying Indian products. So Dabur kind of, you know, was able to generate a good deal of income way, way back in 2008, 2009 by moving into Dubai. This is the next one. This is also a typical expansion on, or a play on, why Indian people who are resident in Dubai, they would want to take loans for purchases in India. So India Bulls played on that. They probably, like, you know, made available loans to NRIs for purchase of properties in India. And you will, again, this is like, you know, there since ages, you will find people who would be leaving India, and they would have dependent parents, they would have dependent families back in India. So they want to buy property back in India. However, like, you know, the people who are there, there can be aged parents, these people are not really equipped to actually deal with, like, you know, getting loans or these transactions. So if you get something outside of India which is facilitating the loan for you for a property in India, it works very well for you, because you want to pay for the loans from your earnings outside India as well. And like, you deal with all the headache that has to do with the loans. Your family doesn't suffer for that. Like, you know, you are dealing with everything. And you, in India, you're just arranging the property. So India Bulls also played on this typical NRI wave kind of thing. Clear Trip, like, these people are a travel aggregator, and they made available, like, you know, they expanded to Dubai somewhere in 2012. And now they have, like, you know, the online travel market. They are about 63% of the GCC region's online travel market, which is even beyond Dubai. Future Group, like I said, you know, the NRI wave of kind of, you know, buying Indian products out of India. So they were going to try up with Choithrams. That's a retail chain in Dubai. And they were going to, like, you know, make their branded products, like Future Group's products, available in Choithrams. They kind of went into Doldrums because of all the things they are facing or going through right now. But this is what they had looked at working on. Fresh to Home. This is a startup, like, people would believe that pandemic would have impacted all of these things. You know, why would someone expand and why would people go? But this is as recent, somewhere as in October or December 2020. Okay, Fresh to Home is an e-commerce startup which is providing fresh kind of products. Okay, fresh vegetables, fresh fish, fresh meat, in a home delivery. Okay, and they got funded by the Abu Dhabi Investment Office, and like, you know, also the Dubai, an entity from Dubai, and they are now expanding the delivery to Dubai. If you go to the Fresh to Home site, you will be able to see India and UAE. Now, these kind of entities, these are very startup entities. Okay. These are not, they have got really good traction for sure. but they are not something of like, you know, really huge kind of entities. Even still, they see sense in expanding to Dubai. So that is their, again, their first foray, first international foray is Dubai, and then they are looking to expand to more countries. Gems and bullion is always there like gold. I know because I was working with a jewelry retail entity in India, which is like, you know, the holding company was in Dubai, a very well-known brand, in fact. So I know that, you know, gold and bullion is something that holds a lot of attraction.